our channel Fintu and you're watching Friday First Cut series. I am Nidhi Manchanda, certified financial planner and head of training, research and development at Fintu. Women should empower themselves financially and times have changed and now many women are working and empowering themselves by their earning potential. However, it is crucial that women take full charge of managing the money that they are earning and don't risk their financial well-being. Women's Day is approaching and now is the right time to watch this video where we'll be discussing about certain tips for women to manage their finances. The first tip is be involved in money management and don't put it on your father or husband or any other family member. You can certainly take their help but gradually try to take full control of your finances. For this, you should be spending certain amount of your time to understand the basics of finance. The second thing is to have an emergency fund. Now, it is very important for you to have an emergency fund which can help you to take control of your finances in case of an unforeseen emergency situation. So, create an emergency fund for yourself which can range from around 3 to 6 months of your income. We have already made a video on emergency funds, so if you want to check that out, the link will be in the description box. Point number 3 is, apart from an emergency fund, you should also create a short-term investment fund. Now, this is specifically for the time period when you're going on sabbatical breaks. This could be because of your marriage or when you're planning to have kids. Now, this particular amount should range from few months of your expenses to around 2 years of your expenses. Point number 4 is when you are going on career breaks, never ever withdraw from your PF investments. Now you are investing into your PF for your retirement, right? That is the reason it should be stayed invested up to your retirement age. Usually women tend to withdraw their PF investment once they are on break and that you should completely avoid. Only withdraw from PF as a last resort and keep this investment for your retirement only. Point number 5, as a couple, husband and wife, if they are planning to buy a house, then both husband and wife should be the co-owners in the property along with the co-applicants in the loan. Now for all the ladies here, it will give you a sense of security that you are also the owner of the house and not just contributing towards the EMI. By doing this, you will also be able to take the tax benefit that comes with home loan. So usually under home loan, the interest that you pay for a home loan is eligible for a tax deduction for up to 2 lakh rupees. But if husband and wife both take it jointly, both husband and wife can take a benefit of 2 lakhs rupees individually. So total on one particular home loan together, you'll be able to take a benefit of 4 lakhs of interest that you're paying on your loan. To add to this point, to feel the sense of security, women should continue with their single individual bank accounts. You can definitely have another bank account which is jointly held with your husband, but you should not stop your single individual account. You can definitely have it along with your joint bank accounts. So you should have certain sense of security and managing your own money in your individual account. That is what is suggested. Another important point is to have an adequate health insurance policy for yourself. Now we have seen certain instances where women need certain medical attention and certain expenses needs to be done, but at that point of time their in-laws don't support them. And because of that they feel helpless and it is very important that you have your own health insurance policy in place so that you don't have to depend either on your parents or your in-laws for addressing that medical situation. Another crucial point is related to life insurance. So let's say if your husband is the only working member in the family, then it is very crucial that your husband gets a life insurance policy to keep you and your children as the nominees. Further suggestion is that this life insurance policy your husband should take under MWP Act, that is Married Women's Property Act, so that the benefit comes to you and your children only and no other creditors or any other distant relatives comes into the picture and claim that amount. We have already made a video on MWP Act, so if you want to know the details of this, do check out that video, the link will be in the description box. Last but not the least, start investing. Now, women naturally are good savers, but along with savings, you should also invest your money so that it grows in future and you are able to create wealth. Now, when it comes to investing, you can bifurcate your goals into short-term, medium-term and long-term. For short-term and medium-term, you can make investments into debt investments or a mix of debt and equity for your medium-term goals. But for long-term goals, you can definitely go for equity-based investments where you are getting exposure to stock market. Now, here you can also do investment into tax-saving instruments. So what will happen is you'll be able to save your taxes. At the same time, you're also saving for your long-term goals. So it will serve a dual purpose. So this way you can plan your investments. I hope these tips will be useful to you and you will implement it. And I wish you all the lovely ladies watching this video a very happy Women's Day. For any further query, feel free to get in touch with our finance experts. And for more such videos, do subscribe to our channel.